I'm going to fry some lamb chops a la Romana, or at least dipped in egg, breadcrumbs, and then fried in olive oil till very, very crunchy. First of all, because there is always room for a bit of brutality in the kitchen, a bit of cling film, some small lamb cutlets trimmed of most of their fat. Though I have to say, in Rome, they have teeny weeny lamb cutlets. I mean, the eye of the chop is about that big. Eating them does feel a bit like the Massacre of the Innocents. And then another layer of cling film on top. And then you just thwack. If you've got a mallet, use that. I don't. And anyway, I think hitting things with a rolling pin is much richer in comic potential. These really only need a couple of minutes each side just so the crispy, crunchy coating goes golden. And for that reason, they should really be at room temperature before they go into the hot oil. Right. Now, before I start getting the egg and the breadcrumb right, I'm just going to pour some oil in because I want this to heat up ordinary, not extra virgin. You can see that it's yellow rather than that thick, oozy green. It's hard to say exactly how much. It's really easy just to reckon on filling a pan up to about a centimetre's depth. And obviously, the dimensions of your pan will determine how much oil that needs. Okay, on with the oil. Okay, time for some dipping and dunking. First, eggs, just a couple. These are Italian eggs. You can see they're lovely golden yolks. Salt and pepper, and season them well because you want these to be intensely savoury. And it's just a question of whisking to combine. This is really just a glue for the breadcrumbs later. You don't need to get it frothy or anything. Now, into the breadcrumbs, you want to grate a good 10 grams of Parmesan, and that's probably enough to fill an American quarter cup full, pretty generously. Anyway, I'll just go by eye. Now, breadcrumbs are not difficult to make, but it's slightly tedious. You have to get good bread, you have to leave it to go stale, and then you have to grate it all, process it. And I found the easiest way of making breadcrumbs quickly is just by getting some pita bread, splitting it, in about 20 minutes it's dried out, and then you just need to process them. And I've really processed 3 pita breads here. That comes to about 175 grams of ordinary breadcrumbs. Right, just mix the cheese into the breadcrumbs. Mm, very therapeutic. Okay, now it's just a question of dipping the chops first in the egg, and then in the Parmesan sprinkled breadcrumbs. Just wodge it in and heap the stuff over. I find that easier to press on. This is a really wonderful weekend cooking because children love doing this. And while I might not exactly leave them alone for a bit of deep frying now, you can leave them alone at this stage. And I'm a great believer in child labour in the kitchen. Have to be some compensations. So just in, and I wouldn't do more than about 3 in a pan of this size at one time, otherwise the heat will drop too much, and it's that which makes fried food get greasy. If you cook in hot fat like this, everything stays so crisp and light. Now, see, I'll just turn these over. Oh, lovely. Just a minute or two on each side until the crumbs are a deep, deep gold. You know, this is so simple, so quick. You could make huge batches of this and cook them all before a picnic without breaking into the merest hint of a sweat. I mean, look at that. Isn't it beautiful? Just want to bite straight in at the risk of taking all the skin off the roof of my mouth. If anything could make a picnic bearable, it would be these. Just gotta crunch straight in, isn't it? For a perfect picnic hamper, partner the crispy lamb chops with my fail-safe, low-effort potato salad. Just scoop out the scorched flesh of a few baked potatoes when they're cold and souse them in cumin, lemon juice, salt and olive oil and a scattering of spring onions. For a green salad that won't wilt or go soggy however long it sits in its tub, try fennel simply dressed with lemon juice, oil and salt and the finely chopped fronds that feather the top of the bulbs.